Hi everyone, welcome back. Do you want to customize the look of your scheduler appointments? Then you must watch this video to learn how easily you can change the look of the appointments using the built-in template option available in the React scheduler of Syncfusion. Look at this example where you can see the completely customized appointments with attractive colors and images. So, in this video, first I will show you how to change or customize the basic appearance of the appointments using built-in event template option, and then I will show you how to set the view-specific customization on appointments. The React scheduler provides a built-in event template option to support such customization, through which you can access all the built-in fields as well as the additional fields of scheduler appointments like subject, location, start time, end time, is all day, and so on. All these fields are directly accessible within the template design, and you can access them using the usual field names inside the template design. Now, I will move on to the example to show you how to customize the appointments with such template option. Here, I am continuing with my existing application where I have already added appointments using a local JSON data. And I have also set the selected date property to 7th May 2019 as this particular date range holds the set of appointments in the data source. In case, if you want to know how to add a simple appointment to the React scheduler, please look on to my Getting Started video, and you can also find its reference link in the description part below. Here, I have planned to display the appointments in different colors, so let me customize the appointments using the template property now. As a first step, I will add the template property to the scheduler and assign it with the template design function named event template. Now, I will define this event template design within which I can access the appointment field details directly. So, I am defining a div element and accessing the appointment data source field subject alone here. While accessing this field name within the template, I should make sure whether the same casing and naming are followed as it is defined within the event field settings. Okay, so far I have shown you how to define the event template design. And now, you can see the scheduler displaying the subject text alone here. Next, let me proceed to show you how to change the appointment color. For that, I may need to define some additional CSS styles for this template wrapper class inside the CSS file. So here, I have set the background color for appointments, some padding values, as well as font size and font weight for the appointments. There is an additional customization needed for the selector e-appointment details, where I have overridden its padding value with 0, and the selector is nothing but the outside wrapper of the template design, and for better look, I have set its value as 0. Okay, I am done with the customization, and when you look at the scheduler now, you can spot the appointments with different background color and subject text alone displayed over here. You can also notice the same changes reflects as common on all other views as well. In some scenarios, I may want to show a difference in the appearance of appointments on different views. Say for example, if I want to customize the look of the appointments only on month view, then I need to remove this generic appointment template definition from the scheduler first, and then I should start to define the event template option available within every view directive, which allows me to add a unique event template design on each individual view. So, I have assigned this event template on month view and provided the class name as month template wrapper. And then, I have also defined few CSS style for the selector. And now, I am planning to display only the location field over the appointment UA on month view. So, let me access it inside the template design. When you look at the scheduler now, the template customization applied on month view appointments, which displays the location text alone. And if I switch the view to day or week view, you can see the appointments with no customization. This is because I have defined the event template design only for month view. In case, if I define my previous generic event template design within this week view, then you can see the appointments displaying the subject text alone with the provided CSS. So now, you can see the appointments in month view displaying the location, and in week view, the scheduler appointment displays the subject with different background colors. And if I switch on to the day view, you can see the default appearance of the appointment. Okay, so far I have shown you the simple customization that can be done on the appointments UI of scheduler. But you can also apply more complex designs on appointments like adding images, links or anything to it like this. Here, I have displayed the event fields like subject, start time, end time as well as images. Now, let me proceed to show you the code example to add this event fields and images. Here, I have added few more div elements in this template design to customize the appointments with necessary details like subject, start time, and end time. Also, I have added relevant images and background color for the appointments using image element and style attributes. And for better alignment and good appearance, I have defined few CSS styles for all these selectors. So now, you can see the completely customized appointments on scheduler with the highly customized template definition code. You can check the additional CSS definition and its complete working from the downloadable example link, which I have shared in the description part below. Finally, let me summarize some of the important points which we have discussed in this video. We have seen how to customize the appointments as generic for all the views, as well as we have seen how to differentiate the appointment customization on each view. If you find this video as useful, then click the like button and subscribe to our channel too. Thank you once again for watching this video.